Hey folks, in cannabis culture news, it seems that police all over the country are raiding cannabis culture dispensaries. So that's a well-known cannabis activist, Marc Emery, who actually went to jail in the United States for a couple of years for distributing seeds from his magazine, cannabis seeds, so that people could grow cannabis. Police in, I believe it's in Toronto and in Vancouver, and just a little while ago in Montreal, raided his medical marijuana dispensaries. Now, the distinguishment is these are storefront cannabis sales operations. Some of them, I know previously, were relying on people having their medical card from their doctor or the government to have access to those places. Some of these places were operating just so that if you're over the age of 18 or, you know, the age of, age of majority, I guess you call it, in your province, that they would just sell cannabis to you based on, you know, your license or your identification. And this, with legalization looming, you know, just around the corner, the government has said that in spring of 2017, that's when they plan to legalize cannabis. So what these stores are suggesting is that they're remaining open and selling cannabis to consenting adults because legalization is just around the corner, and most Canadians believe that part of legalization should involve easy access to the product. What a lot of people suspect is that the Prime Minister's office is getting basically orders from these large corporate medical companies that have been given licenses by Health Canada to produce medical cannabis. So there are about 33 companies in Canada right now that are licensed by Health Canada to produce large quantities of medical cannabis for everyone in Canada who needs it medically. They have facilities that are the size of warehouses, like football fields, like multiple football field size warehouses that grow large quantities of cannabis and store that securely and send it out to people in the mail who are allowed to order it via their medical exemption. Now, stores have been operating all over Canada that call themselves dispensaries, sometimes compassion clubs, and what they do is provide a storefront place where a medical marijuana patient could come into the store and actually observe the medicine that they intend on purchasing by either smelling it or looking at it or talking to somebody about it or getting reviews on it, so that they can determine if they think that medicine's going to work for them. Where this conversation and this communication is not exactly available through the licensed producers, the ones that are ordained by Health Canada as being safe, which I don't want to fail to mention that they've had their problems as well. One of the medical cannabis suppliers licensed by Health Canada, I believe it's Metrum and Organigram, are both embroiled in a class action lawsuit right now, and that's because they used pesticides that are banned in medical marijuana during their production. So there are some pesticides that are okay to use, that are considered organic, that you can use on plants that are intended to be smoked. Now, there's a whole different variety of pesticides when it comes to plants that are intended to be eaten and consumed in that way. So, for instance, something that you might put on a tomato could be easily washed off, and something that you would put onto a herb that is smoked could not be as easily washed off. So some of the chemicals, pesticides that were used in one of these licensed producers' grow operations was actually hidden in the ceiling tiles when Health Canada came to do inspections, so that they knew it was bad. They knew they were using a chemical that, when you spray it onto a herb, if that herb is later combusted, and that's usually the intention when it comes to medical marijuana, that they roll it into a joint or put it in a pipe and smoke it with a flame. When the flame hits that cannabis that's covered with this pesticide they've used, it releases hydrogen cyanide. And that's a very dangerous chemical that you don't want to be ingesting, especially if you're using the cannabis for a medical purpose in the first place. Last thing you need is to be exposed to some more dangerous chemicals like hydrogen cyanide. So these licensed producers, they have their issues as well. There was, I think, a test done by I want to say it was Global News, but you know, don't quote me on that. It might have been one of the other large news organizations, but they purchased cannabis from a bunch of different dispensaries and did tests, and the results are in one of their articles there. And I think they found that something like half of the samples that they got weren't very accurately labeled, and like some of them did contain different types of mold and pesticides as well. So I think one of the major issues is that Canadians are having a very tough time finding a safe cannabis product. And the Prime Minister's solution for this seems to be basically arrest anybody who's running one of these storefront cannabis, you know, unauthorized by Health Canada type locations. And then, you know, eventually when things are legalized, they'll be turning it over to the big companies that have run the medical cannabis industry in Canada for the past couple of years. So a lot of, you know, cannabis activists are saying that this really isn't fair, and that what they'd like to see is the ability for there to be storefront dispensaries where, you know, a place like Medicine Hat, a small town like Medicine Hat, could have a store with various types of cannabis and cannabis products and oils and tinctures and lotions and creams of all types, that you could actually go there and speak to somebody who is an expert in those products, find out more about those products and how they can help you, and you'd be able to make that purchase right there on site legally. That's what a lot of people are hoping for when it comes to legalization. I mean, at least for medical patients, it seems like that would be something that they should have access to, much like a pharmacy. But then, you know, there's also the side of people that are looking towards the recreational side of legalization, and they're saying that, you know, when things get legalized, they want to have easy access to their intoxicant of choice, I guess I'll say. So, you know, we have a lot of issues when it comes to the legalization of cannabis, and a lot of people are suggesting that the raids that are going on right now all across Canada at these storefront dispensaries, they don't have much to do with safety and protecting the public health, and they have a lot more to do with monopolizing the cannabis market for these big companies that are licensed through Health Canada, have boards of directors and trade on the stock exchange. So I wanted to find out what your thoughts are on you know, the government shutting down these storefront cannabis dispensaries. What do you think legalization should look like in Canada when cannabis is legalized? Do you think there should be stores that you could go into to purchase cannabis from? I guess a lot like a liquor store or something like that. Or do you think it should be something that's relegated to going onto the internet, going onto a website, making an order through the internet, and then having that product shipped to you so that there's so much more public safety involved? Really what I'm suggesting here when I laugh about it is that once again, the government is taking advantage of people's fears to make money. They're saying, you know, there's a whole bunch of public safety issues and we can't just let you guys have this. We have to control it. And in doing that, we're going to have to, of course, charge pretty high amounts of money to control and regulate that for you. I mean, the taxes are just, you know, they're going to have to be high so that we have the money to do this for you. And I look at that and I go, I don't know. I mean, I think it's a pretty harmless plant. It's been around for a long, long time. You know what I mean? Nobody dies from it. So maybe it's not something that we should be so concerned about in terms of public health, spending all kinds of, you know, tax revenue on arresting people who are running medical cannabis dispensaries. I've probably been rambling for far too long now, but I wanted to get that news out there that it's been reported in just about every major news organization across Canada that Marc Emery and his wife were arrested at the airport while trying to go to Spain, and the charges haven't been made public as of yet, I don't believe, but people are saying obviously this is in connection with all of the raids going on at the dispensaries. So tell me what you think about Marc Emery, cannabis culture, dispensaries, and the looming legalization in Canada. And I guess, you know, if you want to include maybe your comments on Justin Trudeau, I think there are even a lot of liberals that will call him a liar at this point. Thanks a lot for watching Community TV. You guys have a great day.